have somebody come up here and buy this book. It's only £5.99 if you want a number one hit single in the official UK charts. Get this book, we guarantee within 3 months you will have a number one. You'll be there on top of the pops, the pole position.
Every step of the way, it's all this stuff. How money. Money's a very strange.
Well, these guys are making some fairly outrageous claims for this, a book they've written which says that if you follow the instructions within, you can have a number one single within 3 months. Yep, sounds fairly unlikely to me too. But perhaps we should take them a little bit seriously, because using one of their many aliases, Bill Drummond and Jimmy Cauty actually did get to number one last year with Doctor in the TARDIS. Cue video.
We weren't surprised at all if we got to number one. That's, you know, we decided, let's have a number one single. Sounds, could be fun. We knew a few people that had number ones. We wanted one. It was on the menu. We thought, number one, yeah, we'll have that one. So we made one and went straight for it, took all the shortcuts.
So are you telling me that this is all you need to have a number one hit?
That's it. All you need to get to number one is this pile of junk, basically.
But first of all, you have to fulfill certain criteria. Otherwise, that golden child position will never be yours. Are you a brilliant musician, a stunning singer? Well, forget it. According to the Time Lord, sell any instruments immediately and split up your band if you're in one. Give up your day job and get yourself on the dole. And if you know that your rich parents are always there to bail you out when things go wrong, sorry, only skint hopefuls need apply. And finally, you've got to really want to do it. When will I be if you qualify on all 5 points, then this is where your pile of junk comes into play. All you need to write a number one is a good selection of greatest hits and dance compilation albums, a pile of your favourite singles, and just any old record player to listen to them on. Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you, never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and hurt you, never gonna
Publishing is the rights that are owned by the songwriter, the person that originally wrote a song. Or if you do what we did, which is get three bits of other songs and stick them together with a bit of sellotape, we had to give a lot of our publishing away, which amounts to 6.25% of the recommended retail price of every record sold.
Now find a studio to record your hit and don't pay more than £40 an hour. How much would it have cost you so far if you'd paid for it?
£10,000. Okay. Well, you haven't mentioned video yet. That's going to be a big one. Will I be famous?
Well, you're already in for £10,000, so you might as well go all the way. The book says you don't need to spend any more than another £10,000 on your video. Frankie Goes to Hollywood's Relax is a good example of a cheap video that worked, getting them to number one with their first single.
The first one was only £6,000.
Was that the first Relax one that you did?
That was the very first Relax one, and that was more to do with the energy of everyone involved, and that just happened, you know, people worked overtime, you know, in order to get that video finished because everyone was just enjoying it. These days, I wouldn't like to make a video for less than £40,000 because, you know, I want to be presented in a good way, you know, in a classy way. You're a work of art, you're the Trevi Fountain. You're a golden heart, you're the highest.
You might think that this is the end of the story, that your fabulous single will trot off arm in arm with the video and race into the charts because it's so brilliant. Think again. This is where the fun starts. You're going to need at least another 10 grand to buy the services of a press officer, a plugger to ensure radio and TV play, and a strike force who go out to make sure that your record is prominently displayed in the chart return shops.
When will I be famous?
It would be an incredibly naive, I'd say even stupid person who thought that a good record gets where it is just by being a good record. It's not the case. The inducements that are made to ensure a record becomes successful are like manifold, and I wouldn't like to, go on record as saying one particular thing or another. But obviously money changes hands. Obviously certain people who are responsible for what turns up on pop TV programmes are given nice holidays in nice sunny places in order that those bands actually, get filmed in those nice sunny places, and that happens. Of course, like, a music paper is more likely to be induced to give a band a cover if they can be offered that cover story in San Francisco rather than Scunthorpe. Of course, a record shop is likely to stock a record and make sure that it gets more prominent display if for every record that shop sells, they get two free to sell. It's just like, basic human greed, which is what the whole industry revolves around, which is what, like, the whole pop business, is about, is greed. And that's the way it works. I don't think that's to say it's corrupt, though, because corruption suggests something underhand, and it really isn't that underhand at all. It's so obvious that, everybody does it and everybody knows about it.
Well, admit it, you're probably a bit interested by now, aren't you? You're wondering whether you should go out and spend your last fiver on this book. Well, to help you, we thought that we'd get the advice of someone who knows something about having number one hit singles. I mean, let's face it, this kind of stuff doesn't come cheap. But this is a man whose name is spoken in hushed tones by industry bigwigs. A man who gently guided the Pet Shop Boys to the top. The man who wrote the immortal line, "When will I be famous?" Yes, Tom Watkins was responsible for the success of Bros. But we're not going to hold that against him. Tom, do you think if you followed the instructions in this book to the letter, you could have a number one single?
No.
I don't think it should be taken too seriously. It is a... It is done written in a light-hearted way, and it's very expensive. If you read the book, it's quite an expensive exercise.
How many bank managers, are going to entertain musicians? Zero. First base falls. You ain't going to get the dough.
Of course, this book comes with a money-back guarantee if you don't get to number one. But by this time, you could have run up a bill of nearly £30,000, so £5.99 ain't going to help you very much. And anyway, the Time Lords claim that they have no money left out of the £500,000 they made from one number one single.
Spectacle. Absolutely skint that.